If you would like to support the channel, then please turn off adblock and refresh the page. Alternatively, use the link in the description below to donate to T1 Patreon. Thank you.
Early rendition of Cosmos, a run with everyone. With the Vanity Fiend. I kept tributing off their ships. Just locking them.
So, when this happens, let me know what you think. I actually do want to get another opinion on what I'm doing with the deck. See if it works. Maybe I'm wrong. I need my rock, paper, scissors cards. Or we can roll dice or whatever works.
Very good.
Five?
One.
Okay. What do you say?
I'll go second.
Okay.
Most decks these days need to.
I hear you. Pot of Duality?
Turn. Tell us the lesson that we should learn.
Yeah. Oh, it's reveal. Sorry, forgot about that. Vanity's Ruler, Darks. I forgot that it was not like you reveal the one you pick, it's just you reveal all. So, okay. Vanity's Ruler, Dark Simorgh, whatever, and MST. So.
All cards I'm very familiar with.
We take the ruler.
Mm-hmm.
Let's just put him on the bottom in any order.
Shuffle.
Oh, shuffle. Okay, that's right. Am I thinking?
Christine just sold an ultimate rare version into the store. It's actually quite pricey.
Believe you. Do indeed. Pass turn.
Mm-hmm. Drop turn. I'm going to play Pantheism of the Monarchs.
Yeah, that's
it's like a Destiny draw. Pitch a Monarch spell trip. Mm-hmm. Draw two.
I'll do it. Banish this from your graveyard. Reveal three from your deck. Your top chooses one. Yeah.
I'm going to do that now.
All right.
And
they're all three the same thing, I'm assuming. Yep. Oh, domain. No. This makes me wish I had taken the MST. And this, of course, is the extra deck, this one, then. Can't special summon monsters from the extra deck. Tribute monster, blah, blah, blah. It gains 800 once per turn. Okay. And then, obviously, yeah. We know how that goes. Gee, I have so much of a choice. Unless it's in your hand, that's the catch.
Well, I remember watching one of your videos saying you were the kind of guy that liked the Royal Oppression there.
Yeah, I was that guy. I was, There was a time when Blade Knight was my favorite card. Royal Oppression followed thereafter. Having the two together was my style for a little while. But I couldn't keep it after, you know. I went to college, I couldn't keep it up.
Yeah, go.
Yeah, that's a thing.
Domain's effect. Mm-hmm. I'm going to lower Aether by two.
Yep. All right. I'm sorry if you
attacked. Normal.
Now, what's your secondary? Special summon, blah, blah, blah. Rest of this. Obviously, you're not doing anything with the extra deck. Use this effect. All right, addition to your normal, blah, blah, blah. In your main phase. Blah, blah, blah.
And I'm basically using him for another tribute.
Target one. Oh, that's kind of fine. Yep. Okay.
Tribute?
Yep.
Aether?
Yeah.
Aether's effect. I'm going to send a prime. And... a tenacity.
Perfect. During the end.
And that'll let me special summon.
During the opponent's main phase.
Kuraz.
Yep, there's Kuraz. Hi, buddy.
Kuraz's effect will go off, and I'm going to target your two backers. But you're getting to draw a card for each one.
In response? Book of Moon. Yeah, probably neither of them get me. This is only normal or special summon. Yeah, not flip summon. Aether. And then the other one is a Mirror Force. Obviously can't do that.
He can turn you summon.
That's right. And then he comes back to hand, I believe. And then I draw only one card, right? Because only this didn't go off.
Yeah, only the Mirror Force was destroyed.
Yeah. So here's the card I draw from Kuraz.
And you turned off that way. So. She's no longer treated summoned.
Yeah. Alright, and that's
my turn.
Okay, draw for turn. That's fun. Pot of Duality.
Okay.
Mausoleum of the Emperor. Vanity Spain. Vanity Spain. Okay. Okay. Take the Mausoleum.
I really wish Vanity Spoon didn't have that extra bit of defense.
Oh man.
It would synergize with my deck so much more.
I hear you 100%, dude. Alright. Well, yay for interesting plays. I know what's going to happen, but I can't do much about it because, I mean, I still gotta play it out, I guess. Oh yeah, you're good. Okay. Play it. Mausoleum's out. Pay 2,000. Now, the first time I've used this, so forgive me if I mess this up.
Okay.
Minus 2,000. Where is enter? Or that's it, right? Yay! We got it. The Vanity's Ruler you knew about earlier.
Mm-hmm. That works for you.
Yeah, that's a good question. Now, this is a tribute summon, though. Mausoleum does not count as tribute summon.
Okay.
Yeah, so you could, if you, you can use the Mausoleum, but if you put out a Monarch, other than Kuraz, yeah, they won't get the, Caius won't get his special. So blah, 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 blah. Obviously, that doesn't apply. Blah, 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 blah. Yeah, so they won't gain 800 once per turn, blah, 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 blah. Cool. Yeah, so it doesn't get the boost. Even so. It's only 1,000 defense, so I'll hit it. It is, right?
Yeah, just 1,000.
Yeah.
Typical Monarchs.
Yeah, typical. Alright. And I'll have something to do after that. Set two. I'll move this a little closer. This is not in the field, it's in my hand. And I will, I guess, pass the turn. So you can't special summon. I can. You can't.
Yay.
Well, then again. Okay. That's a thing. Oh boy. Oh no. Oh no.
Was it you?
Yeah. Yeah. I remember there was at least one warrior squire, normal, special, from your deck. Not your raid. Okay, your deck. Defense. Uh-oh. Now,
which I can't special
summon. Yeah, I can't special it, but you can normal to get it. Oh, you can't special summon the monster that comes out from it. That's right.
I'm playing Death Fender.
If it's sent to the graveyard, target, add to hand, so that'll still happen. Okay, well, fair enough. So you're playing to get it. Wait, why am I shuffling? Well, no, you may not play it. Maybe. Probably, like you said, deck thinning, though.
The movie, the game.
Deck thinning, the movie.
I'm quoting Hard Luck Joe from.
Yeah?
You've seen his channel. What a deck.
Not enough.
It's pretty funny.
Thanks. Glare. I'm going to make this a little bit brighter, see if I can work on the glare a little bit. So, just to see if that'll help. It keeps the old... Not much. There we go. That's... The bottom of the screen is actually here, but now it's out of the glare.
How does this work?
So you hit your number, and then minus, I assume?
Minus 1,000.
Minus 1,000.
Gotcha.
Hey!
So you use your field card.
Mm-hmm. Yep, that's right.
summon Kuraz.
All right. Resolves, targeting.
I'm going to target your ruler and this.
Okay. In response, my body is a shield. So I just want to make sure this works correctly. This does destroy. It's obviously not banish, right? Target up to two, destroy those targets, so that's important. And this, it has to have the effect of destroy for me to play my body.
For me to play my body? Context. No context. Who needs that?
And then I want to see if this negates it, will this one be saved, so on and so forth. Unfortunately, the resolution is... The technical term is...
Blurry.
Yeah, blurry.
And I see why I use the computer.
Yeah, sorry about that. Yeah. Do you remember what my body is a shield?
I know it stops... You pay 1500 and it stops destruction.
I haven't been playing this game nearly as heavily as I want to, and I'm basically relying on my, like, legacy knowledge, my knowledge from way back, to try to remember what these cards do. That one's obvious, that one's I get, and so on and so forth. But my body as a shield, I'm trying to remember the minutia. It's pay 1,500, I got that part, minus 1,500, so that part's required. And loading. When your opponent activates a spell or trap, does not work.
Does he have it?
On the field, except during the damage. So it has to destroy a monster on the field, negate the activation if you do destroy it. So, doesn't work though because.
Yeah, I gave you two turns.
Yeah. So it's a mirror force.
Wow.
I know, right?
Should have proxied off some storming mirror force.
Yeah.
Or rippling.
I knew that was going to happen, but I forgot that doesn't work. Alright, so I'll draw two cards.
And he still has his summon sickness.
Yeah, he does.
So I got a pass.
Well, and you've got a little information too, you know, Alright, so draw for turn? I guess get a little information first. Pot of Duality? All of the pot. I have so much. No. Wow. Okay, this is a thing. I think. We'll take the terraforming.
Okay.
Once again, I will put two vanity spades. I have a fan club. I think that's what it is. Cards with the word vanity. Okay. And then. So, terraforming in hand. I guess I'll play it now for deck thinning. Why not? Getting another mausoleum. I just made you cut the deck. So one card. I wonder what that is. Do your thing, dude. Do your thing.
Hello. Hey, sweetheart. Yeah, I came in the middle of a game.
Lo siento.
Sure thing, sweetheart. Yeah, love you.
Okay, so this was not tribute summoned, so it won't get the boost. I think I'll pay 1,000. Put out a vanity. That's why, by the way. No vanity spade. 1,000. Put that bad boy out. And. Pass the turn. If you want a special summon, I'm going to make you use your combat first.
You're not over there getting decked in stone and stuff.
Let's see.
Oh, queen.
Is this a normal summon?
Normal summon?
Normal? During your main phase, tribute a monarch? You can... Oh, I see. Sorry.
The extra tribute summon.
And that gets past Vanity's veins.
I'll tribute these two.
Oh no! Why?
Alright. For every cost, the Mega Monarch?
Grr. Yeah. So that's the graveyard one, blah blah blah. Okay, no, we're good.
Kaius's effect will go off.
Alright, what do you want to hit?
I have to remind myself, it's been too long. If it, well, I did get a dark monster in his tribute, so.
And if you hit the Vanity Spin, it'll take 1,000.
Right. Target a card on the field, banish it, and if you do, inflict 1,000. Then if it was
dark.
It was a dark, banish all cards of the same name from hand.
Oh, it's Kaius the Mega Monarch.
That will, oh.
You'll banish it from the hand, main deck, extra deck, and graveyard.
So since you use a dark, you get to hit two.
Twice, so.
Yeah.
Vanities, and I'll just hit your back.
Yeah, the one that you don't. Alright, so that's Dark Bribe.
Mm-hmm.
Ouch, that hurts.
And then all of your Vanities Fiends will go out of play.
Yeah, so you search the deck and take them all out? Is that how it works?
Yes, I think it would have banished your Bribe as well.
Yeah, okay, so I'm just double checking to make sure if it's a dark monster. Oh, so the Dark Bribe stays, but the Vanity's Fame goes, because it's a dark monster, banish all cards with that name from the hand. So this is my hand, so you can verify. I don't have any more. Main deck, which means you get to look through my deck. Oh, hey, here's a deck tech. Vanity's Fame. Vanity's Fiend, and you can look through the rest of it while you're at it. My extra deck does not have any Vanity's Fiend, obviously. Alright, so banished. Gone, baby, gone. Good grief, dude. Good grief.
I used to run him at two, but...
Yeah. Just one now?
Just one.
Hey, good when you hit him. And obviously my body doesn't help at all with that, because it doesn't destroy, it vanishes. That's what's
more amazing. All right. Like the three lands.
28.
You still only have two cards in your hand. Like, you've been playing
crap.
As many cards as I've
technical
been
term.
That's crap.
So, hit me for 36, I'm guessing? Oh, I thought it was just 800 during damage calculation.
Only when attacking a monster. Right.
Fair enough. Hit me for 28. Put me to 22. Minus. Where's the. We're good like that. Yep.
Imposter.
God, you're miserable. He's so helpful.
You can't switch something from the extra deck, but I don't see
it. Doesn't look like that's something I'm doing. I'm just gonna call this one. That was it, man.
Another domain.
What's the next? Dang it! Oh well, that happened. Nice, by the way. All right, we'll go on to game two. I like to call it Mausoleum Control or Mausoleum Stun because Tribute Stun doesn't work because technically you're not tributing. Because Mausoleum specifically states they aren't counted as tribute summons. So tribute summon, you can't use it to abuse monarchs to hide. So, yeah. That's a thing. What am I doing? 5. Just got into habit, I guess. Alright, so.
You got priority.
I'll go first. I kind of want that card advantage, but I also want to get all the good control elements out first. Alright, I will deck them first. Where are you, buddies? Mausoleum?
Mm-hmm.
Obvious Mausoleum is obvious. Deck them in, yeah! Huh. The foil facing Upstart Hoban? They gotta get the one upstart out. So, draw my card. Huh. The Mausoleum? a 1,000 Vanity's Fiend. That turn, this is why I go first.
Turn one Vanity's anything is,
oh yeah, on my side, is a thing. And then we will set two.
Draw.
If you're going first, attack. I know, even without special summoning, you have ways to do this, so... Oh no. I know there aren't mulligans in this game, there's magical mallet. Sometimes I wish. All of the cards that you drafted, all of them. Domain? Okay.
Like, if you draft enough cards... Not active.
No.
Just throw that out there.
Fair, fair. Fast. I guess that could be a mirror force. That could definitely be a mirror force.
It's a lot harder to do a draft than this.
End of turn, I'll MST it.
Hit my
screen. Okay. Okay. I'll take that. Guess I gotta swing at it. Oh, okay. And what's your graveyard effect again?
I think you can banish her out to get a banished monarch spell trap back.
If it's sent to the graveyard, yeah. Okay, so no banished monarch spell. Okay, fair enough. That was it. And this is out. These are the hands. Pastor?
Still slow and steady beats, I hope.
So, just playing the control game. This is... I was that guy. I was that royal oppression to keep you from doing stuff. This is my royal oppression.
I gotta pass. I still got brick hand.
It's royal oppression with legs.
Yeah.
I guess. 24? Or whoever's got it. Oh.
You understand it better than me.
I'm trying to get the hang of it. I think just in case you destroy one of them, I'm going to put out the other.
Oh. Don't ring me, bro. Ring of destruction. Oh, no.
I guess it's legal to one, so anything could happen. But no. But no. Yeah, that's it.
Okay, let's unbreak my hand.
So I forget that it's... I did that incorrectly. I was supposed to play this first and hit with both. I just got into a rut from it being turn one, so it's nasty. And you just... Okay. So what's the... You're revealing pantheism? No, reveal one monster.
Okay.
You're playing tenacity.
I set tenacity off of pantheism.
Oh, okay. You're not playing the... I got ahead of myself.
Banish the pantheism.
Deck thin and go. Deck thin and go.
Return.
Oh no. Oh no.
Pantheism.
Okay, that's why.
Where are you?
It almost feels like you'd want Stormforth, but if you picked two Stormforth and anything else, I'd probably give you anything else at this point.
I'm not sure that I'm not missing a cover.
Uh-oh.
Otherwise, your game stack has been compromised.
I mean, we're super casual. We're not, this isn't a tournament, don't worry. If it's not, okay. So we're still resolving the banished pantheism?
Yes.
Okay.
I'm looking for my third pantheism.
So, if I understand correctly, you can use the first side, the first half of pantheism, as many, like, three times in a turn, but you can only use the second side, where you banish it, once per turn, right? Okay.
I can't find it, which is sad, so...
March, yeah. And this is the can't be destroyed or targeted by card effects. Destroyed or targeted? Man. I think I might be able to keep you off creatures enough that I want to give you the return. It's tough, but pantheism is more card advantage in deck thinning, and March stops some control elements, so, you know, I think that's what I want to give you. On the off chance I can actually keep you from doing anything else.
You know, it happens, man.
I guess. The brick hands. Six cards in hand.
Let me tell you a story about
the brick. Strata and brick some more. Here's the card you just gave me.
It probably doesn't help that I'm explaining the logic behind the decision.
Send my deck somewhere.
Sure. I mean, you do what you gotta do. And then play a blocker. I mean, play a set, I guess, just to keep yourself alive. Maybe.
Alright. Use Domain's effect. Lower him by two.
Which one is that?
Fearless.
Okay. So, one trip. Oh, yeah. I think I know what we're doing.
Normal. The tribute summon.
Yeah, you get an extra tribute this turn. Mm-hmm. All right, and what's his win you tribute ability again?
Erebus?
Yeah, do you mind if I take a look at Erebus? Oh, no, not
Erebus. You can interrupt his summon, though. Let's go ahead and summon.
I'm trying to decide if this is worth it. When you tribute this by tribute, send two monarchs below traps a different entry, hand a deck to the grave, shuffle a card from your opponent's hand at Oh, it's at random. That's still. One card. I'll let you drop that. Into the deck. Okay, so card disadvantage. That's good. Once per turn during either player's main phase, it's in your graveyard. Okay, so do I want to let this come down? Yeah, it's a thing.
Mm-hmm. Card in his hand, graveyard, or side of the field.
Hand, graveyard, or side of the field. So, in response, you'll still get the effect, but I'm going to activate Bottomless Trap Hole.
Does this protect?
Let me make sure.
No, it doesn't protect. It suppresses.
Yeah, the tribute, blah, 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 once per turn, blah, blah, blah. Yeah, no.
It just suppresses. It doesn't protect. How unfortunate.
But you'll still get to shuffle a card back in. But it's exiled. It's banished. It's gone, baby. Removed from play. It's, what's another term they use?
Shuffle one of your Vanity Screens.
Alright. Yeah, that's
gone.
That's
gone.
I don't want you getting it back with one of your mini monarch recursions. But as long as it, and that's why we have two Vanity Screens. That's why we pay the extra 1,000. Yes.
I have burned my normal summon, so I pass.
24?
That's good.
And I'll drop you. Try not to make those misplays anymore. But I gotta pass. That's it. The slow and steady beats. That's part of the cost, revealing the card. Add one Monarch Spell or Trap, except Tenacity. Kaius. Yeah, alright. Okay. Yeah, and you're gonna play the Pantheism right after that?
I might have just screwed the pooch on that.
If you want to take that back, it's cool there. Yeah, let's take that back. Tenacity to get something else, baby.
That's one for us.
Okay. That's what I was afraid of. That's what I thought you were getting.
I did not have the discard cost. I was like, should have done that.
Fair enough.
Okay.
So, main phase Stormforth.
Stormforth.
Dark Bribe. The two for one, but you get the draw, so. I'm hoping that, like, even though I know that's disadvantage, I'm 2-for-1-ing myself, I'm hoping that because of cards like Vanity's Fiend, whatever I give you is likely not to be played. So, I think sometimes it's okay. Sometimes okay. I'll give you gas anyway.
I'm going to pay 2,000.
Dang it. Where is he? Show me. Show me your...
This is my super secret tag.
Oh no. Oh no. So you're paying 2,000, you said? Uh-oh. I'm scared.
White Dragon Ninja.
That's a reader. Cannot be special summoned except blah blah blah. Can't spell or traps can't be destroyed by card effects. And it's 27. That is some sweet tech. I wonder why. It's not 24 or 28 attack. It's not
I have out my march
yeah,
in my domain.
That's fair. That's
they protect her, she protects.
True. Now, we won't get domain on this because not tribute, but...
It's a beater.
It's a beater, all right.
Attack.
Mirror Force?
I
forgot about this.
Unless you got something to play on the swing back, that lethal on board. Schwing?
And that's game.
Alright, game 3.
I could turn off special summons or I would have summoned that.
Yep, the Prime Monarch.
The Spanish Monarch spell trap, summon it as a monster.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, that's such good card advantage. Over like 3 turns, draw 3 cards. If the deck really gets going, at least.
I hardly ever use the on-field effect.
Fair enough.
I just dump it and summon.
Yeah, I mean, that's true. I guess it's there if you need it. Helps you to keep... Yeah, it helps you to not get behind, I guess, if you're already ahead.
This is showing me a good reason to bump March up.
Oh, do we want to do sideboards for this one?
I don't have one.
I mean, I do, but anyway, it's all rough.
It's not an art that I have really perfected.
Fair enough. We're dying. I'm gonna get that eventually.
For return of the monarchs?
Yeah, you're good. I'm just looking through my hand too. Okay. Yeah.
Normal idea.
Okay.
Here
comes the tribute. And this is based on how many monsters. Oh. When you tribute. Oh, it doesn't matter how many.
Special summons on.
That's advanced. Okay.
Alright, also lets me tribute some.
Yeah, that's a thing. Alright, what's he showing me? Show me. Make me drop a card from my hand, I guess? Shuffle it back into my...
Tribute Summons.
Yeah?
Fearless.
Yep, okay. So, and it's random, right?
And that will go off.
Yeah.
So, let's see this happens first.
Yeah. Just to make sure. Yeah, at random. Okay.
I'll draw.
Fair enough.
And I'll go for the center card, and
yeah.
He will search an Aether.
Yep. That's good.
Yeah. Card.
I won't look. I still got it. Pantheus, yep, both to get advantage when they're in the graveyard. Banish one of the marks, spell or trap. Okay, so to use Prime, you have to use Pantheus. If we were doing it that way. Special summon this card, blah blah blah. Okay. So, what would you like to randomly shuffle?
Go for the middle card.
Okay. I don't know if you get to actually look at it.
Probably not.
I don't think so. It doesn't say reveal it. Oh! That was the one you wanted to hit. That was absolutely the one you wanted to hit. Okay.
On that resolves,
yep.
I do it.
Pantheon. Alright. That'll do it.
Oh man.
Seems good, bro. Seems good.
Oh man. I know, this is kind of a scumbag move.
Oh no, it's fine. But gee, obviously. I wonder. Yeah. Obvious domain is obvious.
Pretty
I'll
much.
Just
It's a done deal.
Okay. But it's not that great against you because you have no extra deck.
Oh, okay.
Admittedly. It's still something to keep in the main, though, I think. I don't get any advantage out of the buff. You do, so I think it's worth it. Poke. Just because it's Grumpy Cat. You said go?
Yeah.
Okay. Just making sure. Boink, boink, boink. Two in hand.
Chain that. I haven't done this before.
Chain
with an effect on my hand.
Okay. I'll need to know what this is to know how to respond.
Aether's effect.
Which effect is this? During your opponent's main. Oh, yes. If this card is in your hand, banish a monk from the graveyard. Immediately special summon or tribute summon this card. Okay. And then as you tribute summon it, if it's tribute, send two more. So that'll do. That'll work. With different names from the hand or deck, be great.
We're gonna do it again. Oh god, we're gonna do it again.
You're still gonna get that, but. Oh no, I can't! Never mind, it all happens. I cry. And he cries. Oh my god.
Special summon. Kuraz.
Alright, so what are we special summoning? Kuraz with? Okay.
I spent two Monarch spell traps.
You special summon it. Oh, it's not a Monarch. It is a Monarch anyway, but you know, you get the idea. That's what we were talking about before they came out, but it doesn't.
Should act.
Yes.
Also for a tribute.
So you hit a Mirror Force and a Torrential Tribute. I'll draw two. Both good cards to hit, by the way.
I'm going to use the effect, because it has to be a different attribute.
I am going to bottomless the Kuraz, but you still get the effect.
Okay.
No, I can't, because I said it this turn. This is still happening in my turn, right?
Yeah.
This is all still happening in my turn.
Your turn searches Erebus.
Oh my goodness. This rushdown, man. Yeah. Poke? I think you're just going to kill me on the swing back. When it comes back around to your turn, right? You've come pretty close. Yeah, I pass. Yep, that's right. Yeah. So that's a thing. Now this then is the Sword of Damocles. You know it's there, but you kind of have to play through it anyway. But it doesn't negate effects, so even if you lose the monster.
Let's see if I can do a lot of damage.
Alright.
Tribute summon?
Yeah.
For another Aether?
In response, bottomless, but you'll still get both the return and the Aether.
Okay. Send two Monarch spell traps. Special summon. I'll go with what I was going to go for before.
Now, you've already used your tribute summon,
though. I'll go off and search one of another tribute.
Yeah.
Well, joke's on you. I don't have any cards. That's not where I want to be, though.
Special summon.
That's really not where I want to be.
Alright. We're going to try out some silly tech. I'm going to see if this works. Maybe it doesn't, and I'm going to get blown out, but hit me for 28. I have been hit. Star Wars. I'm hit! Alright.
Alright, main phase 2. Let's see if I have any other things I can do.
Amazon Prime?
Alright, banish Eidos from the grave to special summon Adia.
Yep, that's a special, so you can't.
Adia's effect goes off, yep. Summons another Eidos. Eidos lets me tribute summon.
And it just keeps going.
So yeah, this is why I was considering putting a god card in here.
This is me not blaming you at this point.
Who to summon?
Just as a one-of, I guess?
Yeah, probably Slifer, because the ban list tore apart my Slifer deck.
Oh.
Chicken game with two of his face.
Oh, man.
I don't remember what it goes to. I know it's a 2-2. Tribute. These guys for an Erebus. So I got like three chains, his, this, and Adia.
Yeah.
So let's go Adia first and grab back a Pantheism from Banishment.
Yeah. Makes sense.
His effect.
Yeah. I'm just going to shuffle it up while you're doing that so that we can go about
it. March and that. And so if I were to cast two spells, a random card.
Alright. You have a decent shot. I think that's probably dead, actually.
And then your turn.
You shuffled exactly the right card.
The turn was going to grab me.
I had an Earthbound Immortal. So the prohibition on you being able to attack, you know.
Your Majesty's
Fiend. Yeah. No, actually, no, that's not so bad. I'm not sure I have any activated effects still.
I do believe if in my turn, he's still under Aether.
Yeah.
So he would have to come back.
I think you got me then. All right. There you go.
Good to go.
I'm like, is that all?
Actually, I gotta get my hand back down 6.
Okay.
So, I will opt off this for more advantage.
Yeah?
So, now it is your turn.
Hot? I'm gonna try it. Raggy.
Obvious choice is obvious.
Yeah, obvious. I don't want to die. I mean, I guess the mirror force, maybe, but you have ways to destroy it on the field, so I think we have to go about that way. So, put them back. And since we don't have a March Monarch, not yet, give you one more turn and you'll hit it, but. Wait, is that only a 1-0?
Mm-hmm. I have a way to get it in my hand.
I believe you. I just, for some reason, I was thinking that was usually like a 2. Derp.
Let's see if I get any effects.
Mausoleum?
Player's main phase. If he's in the grave, discard a monarch spell trap, target a monster in the grave with 2400 or more attack and 1000 defense, add 2.
When does that happen?
When he's in the grave during either player's turn.
During either player's turn. Okay, so still in the main phase. Discard him in the grave, blah blah blah. Blah blah blah.
So I get to discard a monarch spell trap.
So. You actually don't have any 2400 attack. You have 2800 attack, but not 2400 attack.
I believe he can add himself.
Well, he's not 24, though. He's 28.
It says 24 or higher.
Oh, or more. You're right. You're right. Well, in that case, you have well more.
The only restriction is the defense.
All right. So, you saw me drop it. I'm going to drop the Archlord. Yep. He's back. Guess who's back? Back again.
No special summons ever again.
Not, no, this one's either of us. I do remember that. Not Vanity's Ruler. 28.
That's good. Great deck, man. Just didn't perform. Being an insect, you
can control exactly one picture. And then, one card in hand. That's it. Pass. Earthbound Immortal, why? I mean, you're still going to beat me, though.
Alright, let's try some of your own shenanigans.
Yes.
Contribute your
I think that's gay. I think that's gonna be gay.
And it will be for Vanity's Fiend.
It's gone, baby, gone. Can't attack? No, wait, that's soul exchange makes it not able to attack. That's the one more turn. Okay.
And he doesn't qualify for this because of the pesky 200 defense.
What three with the same name are you going to say? Okay, so not the same name.
I went through too much stuff. Domain.
Domain. Although, spoiler alert, that's actually a game, because if you swing with a Vanity's Fiend, I'm not dead, but I can't get anything else out on the field. So, that will actually effectively be game.
Alright, good game.
Good game, yeah. That was cool. So, you see what I'm trying to do.
Actually pretty similar to the stream.
Yeah, you're not wrong. This is so what do you think of Dark Simorgh?
Christine used to play that in Harpies and play it with
Yeah.
What is that thing? I can tell I my sleeve is on. It's a trap. It's Well, anti-spell fragrance.
Yeah, okay.
And they can't set anything.
Now, obviously if we were going to sideboards, this comes out, because you set basically nothing on that deck, unless you are...
Like, this is kind of boss monster or bust.
Yeah. I guess there was a time when you were setting face down, but by that point I already had one. So, the Dark Simorgh, there are three, there probably shouldn't even be three. It was this or Majesty's Fane, and then the other one goes on the side. And I wasn't sure which way to do it. I would have put in... I mean, your monster effects aren't technically activated except the ones that are during either player's main phase.
Like the tribute for Adia during your opponent's turn.
It's better than dark, but I don't know if it's good or not. Yeah, it's probably, but yeah,
I
probably
can play it. This deck, I think I only run my one Majesties just for special occasions. Yeah.
I hear you.
My older build, I ran three.
I believe you.
And then one...
So, if I can just really quickly do a, and I may make this a different video, but you know what, I'll just show you. The idea basically is, I am hunting with cards like Pot of Duality, Terraforming, Upstart Goblin, for Mausoleum. The deck doesn't really work. It can't win without Mausoleum. It can keep me from losing, but it can't win without Mausoleum. So, using cards like this, once I already have the Mausoleum, Pot can go find a monster. The suite and the main board, there are 13 altogether. There's dark, which is it's the sketchiest to me. I'm not sure if I want to keep it around. There's Vanity's Ruler. I'll show you in a sec. There's Archlord Kristya. And then there's Vanity's Fiend. And so with our powers combined, we are the troll deck. Just both of these say neither can special summon. I lose exactly nothing from that. I mean, it saves the deck a little money, because what good do I get from an extra deck? I guess if I ever got two Vanity's Rulers out, then maybe I could... No, that seems bad.
Overlay for a rank.
Yeah! These guys seem to be the most troubling for people to deal with. They shut down so much of the deck. Now, that's not to say they aren't beatable, of course, and once they remove them from the field, the technical term is I'm screwed. Except, oh, and by the way, and then this guy. Just a one-of I'm trying out.
Play that with Nightmare Archfiends.
Yeah?
Yeah.
And this is the... Let's see. Obviously it attacks directly, you can't attack me, so it sort of puts a clock on my opponent to find an answer. And this is the one that, when it leaves the field, destroys everything and deals 800. Well, it destroys all face-up monsters they control. So if they get below a certain threshold, then even if they would destroy it, they still lose. I'm just trying it out. Maybe it's maybe more of them, but they're fragile, because if the Mausoleum gets MST, that's it. And then I'm running a lot of like control elements, cards like Dark Bribe, the full dark, two dark holes, Mirror Force, the full three, MST, the full three, the one CD I get, where I get the one, yeah, you see a thing, the one, I sort of, it almost just looks like a limited list. Okay, let's see what's on the, what's one, what's two, and then I'll just Torrential, Book of Moon. I wasn't sure about the main board for Book of Moon. What do you think? It helped in that one case, but I wonder if it does enough. One, my body. Which, if I take this and move it to the side, it'll be another my body in the main, just to protect my monsters a little bit more. But that's basically what it's up to. Just these stall the game and keep me from losing once I get there, I guess.
Technically, you could run a second dark hole.
Second what?
Dark hole.
Yeah, there's a second. It's just in here. I only got one out. There's two dark holes, three. Let me actually organize them by like, 3-3-3-2-1-1-1-1-1. What's that, Yu-Gi-Oh! Bridge? 1-1-1-1, access denied. 1-1-1-2, access denied. This door is a bitch. Oh, man.
Okay. Let's play this with anti-spell fragrance. It would actually slow this deck down a lot, because I did a lot of quick spells.
They work well together, but... other than, like, unless I have the combo out, anti-spell fragrance doesn't really do enough, I think. But yeah,
makes
you're
set
right.
The spell, but if he's out, they right. Can't set.
But if I don't have dark and I only have anti-spell, it makes them set the spell.
But he said
is that worth
set.
It? Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like, that works when they're together.
Yes.
But if I only have dark, he's okay. If I only have anti-spell fragments, like say I haven't gotten into the dark yet.
You probably have to be a more dedicated deck, I guess.
Yeah, that's what I'm worried about. But yeah, that's a lockdown. That's a pretty sweet lock. That basically says they can't play any more spells or traps the rest of the game.
Or set their monsters.
Or set their monsters, yeah. So that would be a lock. Maybe next time I'll try out Majesties and Dark. It also would save me life points a little bit. 1,000 versus 2, for whatever little difference that makes. You want to play against another deck while we're here?
No. Do you have any?
This is the only one I have. I meant, like, may I play against another one, I guess is how I should word it.
Absolutely.